Hello
and welcome to Disas Craftwork podcast. I'm Disa from Sweden and this is episode 9, and today is December the 21st, 2014. So welcome. I think this will be a rather quick little podcast episode because I have a lot to do and I really wanted to squeeze in an episode this week, and now it's Sunday evening here, so I'm thinking maybe I'm hoping that this will be uploaded before 12 o'clock in the evening, because I have to get up early tomorrow. So we'll see. I'm also hoping for my phone to love me today, but we all know it really hates me, so we'll see about that too. Anyway, I really wanted to say thank you for all you sweet people that are taking the time to write to me. And there was someone I wanted to thank specifically for something, and I have no show notes this week except for one thing written down, so I'm gonna have to thank that person next week, I think. But thank you for everyone who has sent me messages or written in the Ravelry threads, and for everyone who has joined the group. And for all of you who haven't, please do so. Do so if you want to. It's Disas Craftwork podcast on Ravelry. We are now up to 184 members. So that is really exciting. Really close to 200 members. So I'm really happy and excited about that. And thank you to all subscribers on YouTube and to everyone who has written there. And to, like, just everyone who has written anywhere to me. Thank you very much. because of me knitting on only 3 projects this week, I only have 1 work in progress to show you. Yes, you heard me right. Only 1, that is, might never happen again on my podcast. But I'm keeping that in this lovely bag Emilia got me. No, made me, I mean. And this is a new project I started a couple of days ago. Can't remember now, and I think I forgot to make a project page for this. Oh, crap. Well, I can do it, but now I can't remember which day I started them. I think it's 4 days ago. I have to check. Maybe somewhere I have written that down. Anyway, I started a new pair of socks for hubby. You know, he loves socks I knit for him, and he uses them like every day, so he needs more than 1 pair, and the pair I knitted him last year are broken. So he only have 1 new pair. So I thought I'd start another pair for him. So I have, you know, 2 of them. And I'm knitting them on 2.5 millimeter needles. I think both are, yes, both are Adelaide's. And the yarn is opal, both colors are. And the colors are 5187 and the other is 5193. So these are coming along nicely. And just, you know, I have improvised up a sort of recipe for socks for him. So that is what I'm doing. And they fit him perfectly, he says. So I'm sticking to that. And the other thing I have been working on is my little vertebrae bolero cardigan, you know. And I finished it. And I have woven in all of the ends and I have washed it and it is blocking now on my bed. And I'm thinking I might... I'm gonna get up and try to bring it so you can see a little bit of it. Oops. So you can see that I have actually finished it. I have no idea how much or little you can see, but it's blocking. And I'm quite disappointed in the fact that the stitches here did not... they are still wonky, even though I washed it. So, and there's something I have to fix, but it is finished, it is blocking. So, that is one of my finished... that is one of my finished objects for you this week. And that is one of the things I have been working the most on. And when I was not feeling like working on a sleeve, that's when I started Hubby's socks. And the third thing I have been working on this week is also a finished object. And that is my Regia Stripes socks. And just plain stockinette socks with afterthought heels. And I have matched this up to the row. I don't know if you can see that. The only thing that's not matched exactly to the row are the heels. And I really need to get some sock blockers. Anyway, I forgot to write the colorway down, but it's Regia, as you say, Regia, so as we say it. Regia Café Facette Random Stripes. And the colorway is on my project page, so if you really want to know. And I really like them. I made them long. My socks has to be, if you fold them, they have to be as long as the leg. And this is longer. So that's what I like. So those are done, and I knitted those on 2.25 millimeters. So that is all of my WIPs and all of my finished projects. So you can see this is a quicker episode. I also have another finished object, and that is my Sami bracelet. I don't know if you can see this or not. If it's focusing or not, I don't know. I have it around this bottle because it's gonna be all flat and nice looking. And another thing I wanted to show you is a WIP that is going to be ripped out. And that is this cardigan. and I have made so many mistakes, and I don't know what I am looking with. It's apparently not my eyes. Because, do you see this? This is straight. From here it's straight, and it should be, if I fold this, it should be, oh, it's a, what's it called now? Featherweight cardigan. And I had written down, handwritten, all of the numbers on one side, and on the other side, I had written down my own, like, top-down recipe that I invented the first time I wanted to try top-down. I wanted to know if I could do it without ever have read a pattern for it. So I was thinking, like, oh, how hard can it be? And, you know, I started it, and it worked out pretty good, actually. I made a cardigan, and since then I have made others, and I have changed my little pattern to be more, to be better, I mean. And I accidentally followed that pattern instead of the, what's it called now? I just said it, featherweight cardigan. And apparently I have no eyes, because, you know, if I would have looked at this, I would have seen this is straight out from the increase section, or what's it called. So I'm ripping this out completely, but I am totally going to make a cardigan. Not right away, maybe. I might not be ready for that yet. But I am loving these colors together. I am loving the yarn and everything. And this is a lace weight, knitted on 3 millimeters. And I love. Oh, it's so soft. I love this. So I have to make it again. So I'm ripping this out and starting it again at some point. So that I wanted to say. And also because of me not having so much, like, is it called content, maybe, to talk about? I thought I'd talk about this. Because this is redwood. And I don't know if you can see, but I have them everywhere in my stash. Just, I have them everywhere. And I have redwood oil, so I drop that on these, like once a month or something like that, and I have it all over my bedroom. And that is because I know that this works. A couple of years ago, I don't know, 5, 7, I don't know. I had just gotten these, and I put them in my stash, and I had my stash in the living room. And I went away for like 3 weeks, and when I came back, I had those little... oh, crap. Now I realize I don't know what those are called in English. In Swedish they are called pälsängrar. You know that little animal that looks like a... Oh, I don't know the name for that either. Oh, why did I not look this up before? Anyway. You know that little animal that is eating wool? And not the flying one. Not the moths. Not that one. The other one. And I had under the couch, I had a lot of them. And since I was gone for 3 weeks, those little things, to put it nicely. Got to, you know, make babies. What are those called? I can't think of it, so I'm gonna call them babies. And they've made a lot of them. I am not kidding you, I had a lot of them. And of course I had dropped a wool blanket on the floor. And that, you know, they were loving that. And they were everywhere except for my yarn stash. Not even one of them had gone to my stash because of these. So they were in every other wool and every other things. Like fabric, blankets, they were everywhere but not in my stash because my stash was protected. I am really relieved and happy about that. So I can't say enough good things about Redwood, and I will always keep it in my stash. Everywhere in my stash. I have it on every shelf and, you know, everywhere. So if you're not protecting your stash with Redwood and you have it up, get them. Get a lot of them so you can have them everywhere. So that I wanted to say. And I also wanted to show you some yarn I love and I am probably gonna cast on maybe next month or so, because this is a sock yarn I love. It's Sweet Georgia Tough Love Sock in green colors. I really love this. I don't know if you can see if it focus or not. And you know how I am with American yarns. I love them. And this is another sock yarn, but this is like maybe sport weight or a DK or something. It's Lorna's Laces. What's it called now? Sportmate or something. Yes, Sportmate. And it's 270 yards on a 100 grams skein. And this is the color Mother Lude. Lude, I don't know. And I really love these colors together. You know, it's purples and mustard yellow, brownish, you know, a little blue and, you know, a little of everything. No, not everything, but, you know, I really love this. So this is gonna be socks for me, I think. And another yarn I love really much is Rowan Fine Art. And I absolutely love this yarn, and I have tried it. It's a really good sock yarn. And it's made with merino wool, kid mohair, polyamide, maybe you pronounce it like that, and mulberry silk. And it's so soft and it's really good. And this is, maybe it's written down somewhere, I can't find it now, but I have it on my stash on Ravelry. It's a really great yarn and I love all the colors in it. So those I really love and will knit in the future with. So I wanted to say, because I was really frustrated yesterday because my friend Emilia, sweet Emilia, who is a meal carve 1963. She gifted me a pattern on a really lovely cardigan I had in my queue, and I really want to knit it, and she gifted the pattern to me. And I don't understand the whole pattern. So I was reading it over and over again because I wanted to cast it on. I have yarn for it and, you know, I really wanted to cast it on. But I don't understand it all. So I get really frustrated and I was really trying. But my brain couldn't handle it. It was, you know... Oh, I don't know what's wrong with my brain. I couldn't understand everything. So, I don't know. I'm not gonna cast that on, but I really wanted to. And right now, I wanna cast on all the things. But, you know, I have to wait to see if what Amelia sent me will arrive. We have 2 mailing days left before Christmas. It's Monday and Tuesday because we don't get mail on Saturday and Sundays. And we don't get mail on, like, Christmas and Christmas Day and, you know, special holidays, like, type. We don't get mail those days. So it's 2 days left, so Amelia and I are really hoping the package will get here, but you know, the post is in Sweden can be horrible. You know, sometimes I don't even get packages someone sends me, so we really hope that it will arrive and to see what she has planned for us. So... I am trying not to cast anything on, but I really, really, really want to cast something else on because, you know, I have finished 2 objects. So I'm itching to cast something new on. But I don't know what, and I don't know in which yarn. So I'm gonna have to think about that. And, you know, I have... other socks on the needles. I should really... I have 3 pairs of socks except for hubby's. So I have 3 pair of socks on the needles that's for me, and I should get back to those because they have been untouched, if that is a word. So I have to think about things like that, and I think that if her package doesn't arrive, I have to have some kind of a backup plan, maybe. And I have to think about what yarn I will use for casting on with Little Bobbins Knits podcast. Because I want to join in on that, because, you know, I'm always knitting socks. So I am really looking forward to having a new pair of socks on the needles. So that is things I'm thinking about. And I also wanted to say that I made the second part of my tutorial. And I am really happy that I managed to do that because, like I said, it has been crazy busy. And I am not happy with my tutorial, like, skills. But I have done my best, and I have had a lot of technical issues with my phone. And I thought I would be better at it, but I wasn't. So I'm hoping everybody understands everything. Otherwise, you can just, you know, PM me or write in the Sami Bracelet Craft Along thread. And I was so thrilled to see a finished... I don't know if she... I can't remember now if she had joined in on my... on Sarah's and I Craft Along for the Sami Bracelet or not. Because my memory sucks. But I have seen one finished Sami bracelet, and that was so much fun. And then Sarah from Fiber Trek, that I have this joined craft along with, she has she had finished up until the point where my tutorial, my part one of the tutorial, as far as I had shown everything in part one. So she was just waiting for part two. So I am happy that I managed to squeeze that in today, so that people at least have a chance to finish their bracelets before Christmas if they wanted to. So I hope I hope it's watchable and understandable, that I'm making sense and stuff, but you know, I'm not thinking I will make any more tutorials, because there are great tutorials. Like I said, there are many different great tutorials out there in different crafts, and I wasn't good at making a tutorial by myself, so I probably won't do it again. And I want to say Merry Christmas, or as we say in Swedish, God Jul, to everyone. And I am not sure I will be recording next week. I don't think so. There might be a little something extra, but not an episode. And I'm not promising anything. But there might be something for you to see next week. So, have a great Christmas. And I hope I will see you when Christmas is over. I don't know when I will record the next time. It's gonna be a little bit crazy, because my son is turning 20, and we are having a 20-year-old birthday party for him. I don't know when I will record again, but I am hoping that I will make one more episode. And a little, one more episode this year, and maybe a little something next week. But I don't know if I will, but I am thinking about it. So everyone, God Jul, bye!